Good evening to fellow Toastmasters and dear guests. With immense pleasure, I welcome you all to our 831st meeting of Chennai Toastmasters Club. The mission of every Toastmasters Club is to provide a supportive and a positive learning experience in such a way that the members are empowered to improve their communication skills and leadership qualities, hence resulting in greater personality growth and self-confidence. Members of the Toastmasters are guided by a set of essential core values: integrity, respect, service, and excellence. Before moving on to the meeting, I would like to brief upon certain rules to be followed. Kindly keep your mobile phones on silent mode. Do not talk about taboo topics such as politics, religion, and sex. Kindly be on silent or stay on mute until it's your turn to speak. We strongly advise to have your videos turned on for a convivial meeting experience. I hope everyone is all set and ready to get into the meeting. Now it's time to introduce our presiding officer for the day. Our presiding officer for the day is Madam Toastmaster Abhirami. She's working as an audit manager at PwC. She's a passionate and diligent Toastmaster. As a Toastmaster, she had been an ExCom member as SAA, VP Membership, VP Education, and she's our current president of the club. So let's welcome our presiding officer, Toastmaster Abhirami. Stage is yours.
Thank you, Toastmaster Vishnu, for those warm words of introduction. A very good evening to all the fellow Toastmasters out here, and a special good evening to the guests who have joined us today. In life, have you noticed that some people are always cheerful and happy about whatever they're encountering, while some are really worried and anxious about what life is going to bring to them? But why is this difference? Both the set of people know that they are not able to predict the future, but the way they think is different. Why is this diversity? Now, this difference is because of their confidence or their thought about their ability to control their future. I had all these questions within myself because most times I used to be very anxious. When I read this book called The 7 Habits of Highly Effective People, I realized one key thing: that in the mind of a positive person, they have a clear segregation of things. Things that are within their control and things that are beyond their control. Once they do this beautiful segregation, they're able to act upon what is within their control and thus make their life better. Now, even this example will correlate to what all of us are doing here. These 2 hours in our life, every week, we are spending to improve ourselves, make ourselves better. We are continuously sharpening our axe to just become the best version of ourselves. So this is something within our control. But tomorrow there is an opportunity at your workplace or at your college where you have to speak. Now that is what life throws at you. So let's all be ever ready, prepared, and have a clear mindset of how to handle life. Now, on this quick life tip, let me formally declare meeting number 831 open. I would like to formally recognize the presence of our founding member, distinguished Toastmaster Nina John. Welcome to the meeting, ma'am. She is the founding member and also the District 120 Mentor Pool Chair. And also a special welcome to all the guests, guest Yadesh. Yes, so we have one guest at the moment. Welcome to the meeting, Yadesh. Thank you. So now let's get into the meeting. Let's start with hearing the secretary's report. Request Toastmaster Vignesh to read out the secretarial report.
Yes, Abhirami. Hi, good evening, everyone. Hope my screen is visible. So last week we had 830th meet. It was a hybrid meet, and we have enough number of speakers, members in the members and guests participated in the meeting. And Sergeant Atam Toastmaster Abhilash stated the meeting, opened the meeting, and the presiding officer Toastmaster Lakshmi Narayana declared the meeting 830th. And Toastmaster of the day Vignesh explained about listening and hearing and conducted the meeting. And the general evaluator explained about the evaluation, and he introduced the tagging. Word of the day was sagacious, which means having or showing an ability to understand difficult ideas. Example, student reviews paint the writing professor as a sagacious mentor and a compassionate teacher. And we have two prepared speech One is given by Toastmaster Shatish, which was an icebreaker speech. He shared about his life journey. And the second speech was given by Toastmaster Sharath. It was a level 3 project 2 speech. It was from Presentation Mastery. So he shared about the secret mantra to live a happy life. And the table topic master was Toastmaster Bharat Kumar. He conducted the table topic session very well and everyone participated. General evaluator comment was all the role player did an excellent job and the recommendation were meeting need to be started few minutes earlier as it was hybrid meet, there was some delay, so which need to be improved. And earlier we had 3 prepared speeches. Nowadays the prepared speech count is reduced, so that also need to be increased. These are the recommendations from GE. And presiding officer Toastmaster Lakshmi Narayana adjourned the meeting for today. Thank you. Over to you, Toastmaster Abhiram.
Thank you, Toastmaster Vignesh. Now it's time to get into the meeting for today. For this, we have the Toastmaster of the day, who is a very familiar face in this club. Now, I'll request Toastmaster Lakshmi Narayana on stage. Even before that, just a few words of introduction about Toastmaster Lakshmi. He is the present VP Education and he's the upcoming president of CTM. He's been with CTM for a couple of years and he's performed various XCOM roles. He's been a very active member. Also, he was a part of the latest Speechcraft session that we conducted. He was taking a lot of interest in all such activities. So with this introduction, let me hand over the stage to the Toastmaster of the day, Toastmaster Lakshmi. Over to you, Lakshmi.
Thank you, Toastmaster Varani, for your kind words. Good evening, Toastmasters, guests, and my dear friends. I'm going to be the host for this meeting for the next 2 hours. Do you know what day, what is important on 12th of June, that is today? There are several international days and national days today. I'm going to pick one day for that as a theme. So what is it comes to your mind when it's 12th June? You can Google it and you can say yourself. What is special about today? It says International Loving Day, National Palapal Day. There are many such days. But very importantly, today it's been on news that International Child Labor Day. Actually, the word means Child Labor Day, but it should have been very specifically as World Day Against Child Labor. The Child Labor Day means it's a World Day Against Child Labor. The significance of this World Day Against Child Labor is to pay attention to the problem of child labor and to find ways to eradicate it. This day it's been it's been used to spread awareness about the harmful mental and physical problems and issues faced by children who are put into child labor. It's not just for India, it's all over the world. And today, United Nations has also observed this day as a World Day Against Child Labor. And this year's theme is Universal Social Protection to End Child Labor. So I've been talking about this child labor and child labor. So what is child labor all about? So child labor refers to work that is mentally, physically, socially, or even morally dangerous and harmful to children, and which interferes their schooling. See, the kids who've been deprived of going to school or deprived of attending a school by obliging to leave school prematurely, just in kindergarten itself, or even primary school itself, is known as child labor. I will get into detail about this. We'll talk more about this in the next part of this meeting. And let's begin this meeting now. So let me explain for the benefit of the guests, I'll explain the about this meeting, today's meeting very specifically. As usual, like any other meeting, we have 3 important sections for this meeting. The first one will be the prepared speech section, where there are 2 speakers today who will be delivering a speech which they prepared as per the project objective. They would have rehearsed it, got it reviewed with mentor, and then they're going to come and deliver the speech in front of us. The second section of this meeting would be the table topic session, the impromptu speech section, for the table topic master, we call the non-dual players predominantly and give them a random topic. So they have to talk on the topic for 1 to 2 minutes. And the last part of this meeting will be the evaluation session, where the set of evaluators will evaluate these speeches, the prepared speeches, and also other parts of this meeting. So with this, the very important key part of this meeting is the evaluation. And so to do that evaluation, we have a general evaluator. The general evaluator who will take care of this quality of this meeting through this meeting. And today's general evaluator is our very own presiding officer, Toastmaster Abhirami. The Toastmaster Abhirami, to just give a brief introduction of her, because we are just mutually exchanging our role explanations, I think. So Toastmaster Abhirami is a chartered accountant by profession. She is working in PwC. She had taken several roles in Chennai Toastmasters Club, including Vice President Membership, Vice President Education, and currently the President of CTM. And just to mention that I'm following her footsteps in all these roles, and she is constantly guiding me in all these roles as I take up these roles after her. And not to forget, she's the winner of the ISC contest distinction level. I welcome Toastmaster Abhirami to come and explain her role as a general evaluator. Over to you, Toastmaster Abhirami.
Thank you, Toastmaster Lakshmi. So now, as the general evaluator, I'm here to talk about what I would be doing and also how my team will be supporting in the process. Now, the name of the role is general evaluator. As the name goes, I'm here to generally evaluate what is happening throughout the course of the meeting, right from the starting to the transitions to the way we close. Now, to support me in my role of evaluation, I will have two teams. Now, even before introducing these two teams, if you ask me, why do we need an evaluation for a club where people are speaking and trying to improving? Now, one key element that I would like to remind to all of you here is that we are all here constantly endeavoring to become a better speaker and a better leader. And to become better, we need someone to constantly give us a feedback and drive us on a path of better performance. So to facilitate that, this team will be giving their feedback today. Now, the first team today is the TAG team, which is called TAG here stands for Timer, Hour Counter, and Grammarian. So I would now request the timer to come on stage and explain his responsibilities. Now, to say a few words about the timer for today, we have Toastmaster Palani Sami. Toastmaster Palani Sami is a leather technologist. He works with Wettgreen, which is a Germany-based company. When I asked him what he loves doing, he says that doing his work perfectly makes him very happy. So I'm sure he's going to do a great job as a timer. Over to you, Toastmaster Palani Sami. Palani Sami, you're on mute.
Yeah, good evening, fellow Toastmasters, friends and guests. As a timer, my role is to count the time in which every speaker is taking to complete their prepared speeches, as well as to count the time taken for individual segments like table topic and speakers of table topic. So at the end of the meeting, I'll be presenting my report on the timer. Thank you, and over to you.
You're on mute, Abhirami.
Okay, sorry. Thank you, Toastmaster Palani Sami. So now we will move on to the R counter. So to explain the role of R counter, we have Toastmaster Mathu. To say a few words about Toastmaster Mathu, Mathu works in Barclays UK Bank on the IT side. And when I asked him what makes him happy, he again says whenever he completes its task on time, he's happy. And his hobbies are reading magazines and traveling. So with this introduction, let me request Mathu onto the stage.
Yeah, thank you so much, Toastmaster Abhirami. So good evening, all the Toastmaster, fellow Toastmaster and then guests. So today my role is to be the accounter. So the purpose of accounter is to note any overused words or filler sounds used as a crutch by anyone who speaks during this meeting. So words may be inappropriate interjection, just as well or but, so, and you know, and the sounds may be right during this evaluation portion of the meeting. So I will report the observation when you called upon by the general evaluator. So over to you, Toastmaster Abhinav.
Thank you for those details on the accounter role. Now we will hear from the grammarian. So the grammarian for today is Toastmaster Shivakumar. To say a few words about Toastmaster Shivakumar, he works for DSV Logistics Company as the HR business partner. So when I asked him what he likes, he says that he likes driving and spending quality time with his family. And he's a passionate singer and artist, looks like. So now I have company for singing. That's great. So over to you, Toastmaster Shivakumar.
Thank you, Toastmaster Raghunavi. Good evening, fellow Toastmasters and guests. As a grammarian, it's my responsibility to pay close attention to all speakers, listening carefully to the language usage, and I will take note of any misuse of this language, as well as any outstanding quotes, words, saying, and thoughts. As a grammarian, it's also my duty to produce the word of the day. For today's meeting, the word of the day is audacious, which means willingness to take risk. I'll give an example. The most successful people are those who are audacious taking risks. I request all the speakers, please use the word of the day as much as possible. I will give you the word of the day report, grammatical usage report, when called upon. Thank you, Toastmaster.
Thank you, Toastmaster Shivakumar. I'm sure all the people who are performing in table topics will raise up their hands audaciously to play the role. So thank you. Now, the next team that I was talking about, apart from the TAG team, is the set of evaluators. So that team, I'll be introducing them towards the later part of the meeting. So with this, let me hand over the control to the Toastmaster of the day, Toastmaster Lakshmi Narayana. Over to you.
Thank you, Toastmaster Abhirami, for explaining your role and your team's role together. Thank you so much. And now it's time to begin our first and the most important session of this meeting, the prepared speech section. Today, we have two prepared speeches. One is going to be the icebreaker speech, another is going to be a level one speech. Let me introduce the first speaker. And today's first speaker is our Toastmaster Vivek. I called him to mention as Vivek, but his full name is Vivekananda. Toastmaster Vivekananda is working as a senior HR executive in Zealous Services, and he's joined Toastmaster very recently, and kudos to him for making an effort to give his icebreaker speech as soon as he joined the Toastmasters. And before calling Toastmaster Vivek, let me invite his evaluator, Toastmaster Hamsikar, to explain the objective of this speech. Over to you, Toastmaster.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster of the day. So coming to Toastmaster Vivek, the purpose of your project is for the member to introduce themselves to the club and also learn the basic structure of a public speech. So this is a level one and pathway one speech, and all the very best to you, Toastmaster Vivek.
Thank you.
Thank you, Toastmaster Amsika. And now I'm going to invite our Toastmaster Vivek, and the title of the speech is going to deliver a speech about myself. Toastmaster Vivek, the stage is yours.
Right. Hello, am I audible?
Yes.
Correct. Success is not a final, failure is not a fatal. It is the courage to continue that counts. Good evening to all the Toastmasters and dear guests. My name is Vivekanandan, working as a human resources professional in Zealous Services. I am 32 years old right now. As of now, I can split up my life into three phases.
The first phase of my life was really joyful and excellent. Because during my school days, I am the most favorite student to all my staffs, except only one, that is my mathematics teacher. Because I'm not too good in mathematics. Apart from studies, I am a hockey player, as well as I used to cricket too. I am very much interested in sports and games, equally to studies. I used to participate in most of the competitions, and I won prizes too. Second phase of my life was really a vague one, because I want to become a hockey player after completion of my schooling. But due to my parents' compulsion, I joined in engineering. My college life was really a boring one, because I struggled a lot to clear my papers. I can simply say I just completed the course in engineering, but I didn't learn anything from it. As you know, right, because the person who is not at all too good in mathematics done his engineering. Just imagine how, because that much struggles I have faced while completing the degree. Then second phase of my life, then after completing my degree, my parents asked me to go for the higher studies, but I preferred to get a job in the government sector. So I started preparing for the TNPSC exams. I took nearly 2 years to prepare the preparation, but I am unable to clear the exams. I got failed. Later, I started my career as a HR in a job consultancy. I worked there for a period of 1 year. Then again, I quit the job and I started preparing for the SA exams. This time, I cleared the written exam as well as the physical exam. But due to my cutoff marks is low, I didn't get qualified for the next level. Again, I got failed. Later, with my previous experience as a job consultant, I started a business of my own. Things really went well for a period of 8 months, but due to improper finance management, I had a big loss in my business. As a result, I've fallen into a debts. The third phase of my life was really a tough one, but I learned a lot of things in practical. Because I joined in a company called Zealous Services, which I am working now. I really worked hard there for a period of 1 year. It took almost 1 year for me to clear all my debts. And then in the year of 2019, I got the Employee of the Year award. And in the year of 2020, I got the Best HR award. Later on, I completed my MBA in part-time. And then in the year of 2021, I bought a car of my individual house for my parents. Then later on, to upskill myself, I plan to start two things in the last year. The first thing is, I joined a PGPMX course in the Great Learning by last month. And then I joined in Toastmasters too. And I hope these two things will help me to upskill myself in my career. As I said in the beginning, success is not a final. Failure is not a fatal. It is the courage that continue to count. I think and I hope I have that count. So don't get afraid of failures. So whatever happens in life, face it with courage. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Toastmaster Vivekanandan. It was a wonderful speech. The way you started the story about all the failures, though you started with a message about success, you started all the failures you faced across and how you came across your life. You literally made us walk through your life from your the three stages of life. Thank you, Toastmaster Vivekanandan. I wish you all the best. I expect more such speeches in future as well. And Now comes the second speaker, and it's time to introduce our second speaker, Toastmaster Geeta. Toastmaster Geeta is a passionate Toastmaster, and she is very passionate in improving her communication skills, and she was our Sergeant at Arms in the past. So Toastmaster Geeta is going to deliver her evaluation feedback speech. Before calling her, let me invite her evaluator, Toastmaster Srikanth Kuttikrishnan, to explain the objective of the speech. Over to you, Toastmaster Srikanth Kuttikrishnan.
Good afternoon, everybody. Thank you, Toastmaster of the day. Toastmaster Geeta has chosen motivational strategies as a part. It's level 1 project 2, evaluation and feedback. Here, there are two speeches which she has to give. The first speech has been given by her, and she has to incorporate the recommendations given in her first speech in this speech which she's about to deliver. And the recommendation that she has got in the first speech from her evaluator then was to add dramatization in her speech. So the objective for her in today's speech is to add more of dramatization when she is going to deliver her speech. And this is the feedback she has to incorporate, for which Toastmaster Geeta Shroff has 5 to 7 minutes. I wish Geeta Shroff all the very best. Thank you and back.
Thank you, Toastmaster Srikanth Kuttikrishnan. Now I invite our second speaker, Toastmaster Geeta, to deliver a speech, Attitude of Gratitude. Geeta Shroff, Attitude of Gratitude. Over to you.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Lakshmi Narayana. So friends, let me begin with a short story. A lady had gone to the beach with her grandson. She was enjoying watching her grandson play on the sand. Suddenly, a huge wave came and pulled her grandson into the sea. The lady was shocked, alarmed. She cried and pleaded to God, saying, "Oh God, please send him back, because he is my only hope to live." Her prayers were answered. Another huge wave came and threw the boy onto the shore. The lady, as expected, was overjoyed, and she ran up to her grandson and hugged him and kissed him. After a pause, she looked up at the sky and said, "Oh God, he was wearing a cap, and his cap is missing now." Good afternoon, fellow Toastmasters and guests. Yes, you understood it right. The lady, instead of expressing gratitude, she complained about the missing cap. Isn't this something that happens with us too? Most of the time, when we should be expressing gratitude, all we do is we focus on the negatives and we complain. I was no different. Now, why did this have to happen to me? I uttered these words more often than I even realized. And friends, I always wanted something more from life and I was never happy. But then an incident happened with me. I had to move to my new home to Egmore. It was my dream house, and my new home was just the way I wanted it. And I was really happy and I was overjoyed. I was excited. Say what not you want to say. But then, friends, this excitement was short-lived. Very soon I realized that my new house had some negative aspects as well. And as expected, I focused on the negatives instead of focusing on the positives. I even had the audacity to tell my husband, "Please, I don't want to live here. Please take me back to our old house. I was happy there." Friends, you can imagine what the situation would be in my house. There was a lot of confusion and everybody was upset. I was in a state of denial. Once my son even walked up to me and said, Mama, do you even understand what you're doing? There are so many people in this world who don't have a shelter of their own. And look at you. You're just not happy with whatever you get. And just think about Papa, what he must be going through, seeing your reactions. Friends, please tell, do you know how I have reacted? My ego got the better of me and I said, Rohit, is this the way you talk to your mother? And the poor boy left crying. But then an incident happened in my life, which I would like to share with you all, which really shook the reality out of me and made me think differently. I met with an accident which resulted in my vehicle, which forced me into being on crutches for 3 full months. It was an experience of a lifetime for me. I realized that I hadn't thanked God for the beautiful body he had bestowed upon me without any breaks until that point of time. I could also empathize with what a disabled person might be going through in this life. Moreover, friends, my review visits to my doctor, or even my first visit when I went to the doctor with my pain, I realized that I saw that there was a lot of suffering around me. I realized that people had a lot of problems, and then I literally thanked God that I had escaped with minor injuries. And I also expressed gratitude to God. This in turn helped me feel my pain as light as cotton, and I was able to wait that period of pain. And friends, probably it was during that time I could align with what my son was trying to tell me. And for the first time in my life, I, from the bottom of my heart, expressed gratitude to God for the beautiful house he had bestowed on me. As rightly quoted by Mary claims, when you look through the eyes of gratitude, everything is miracle. Things changed. Perception changed, the way I was thinking changed, and the chaos turned into order. My denial turned into acceptance, and I was really very happy. And I could say that I was in peace with myself. Thereon, I also realized that it was only by expressing gratitude I was actually inviting miracles in my life. I was amidst chaos outside my home, but then everything inside my home was fine, and I was in peace with me, and everybody was happy with whatever was happening with us. Friends, I realized that when I express gratitude, or whatever you appreciate flourishes, thereon I have been abundant in expressing gratitude. Initially, it was a conscious effort, because it didn't come so easily to me for the kind of a person I was. So the conscious effort was I started keeping a journal wherein I tried to write at least 10 things that I was grateful for during the day. It could be something like as trivial as my being able to go for my morning walks. And friends, within a short time, I realized that the more I expressed gratitude, the abundance I invited into my life.
And our speech will come on.
And so I realized that the more I expressed gratitude, the more abundance I invited into my life. Friends, I realized that when you express gratitude, you actually open the doorway for better health, better wealth, and a lot of happiness, and so much more. So what I suggest you is, let us not make this act of expressing gratitude as an everyday practice, but let us accept it as an every moment practice, so that we invite lot of happiness and lot of prosperity into our homes. Dear fellow Toastmasters and guests, are you all willing to focus on the positives and invite abundance into your lives? Over to you, Toastmaster.
Thank you, Toastmaster Geeta, for a wonderful speech about attitude of gratitude. Because the gratitude is considered to be one of the best and healthiest human emotions. Because the more we express gratitude, the more likely we will be more peaceful, we'll appreciate for the world. Thanks for sharing such an interesting story and how you move from denial stage to acceptance stage. Thank you. And with that, we come to the end of the prepared speech section. And before moving to the next table topic, next session is a table topic session. Let me give a small data about the child labor. Because that's the theme you've been talking about, and today being a child labor day, which actually means a World Day Against Child Labor. So, according to the statistics, there are 152 million children worldwide. They are victims of child labor, of which 88 million are boys and 64 million are girls. The always child labor boys number is always high. So girls who leave school early to take the responsibility course are at homes are also considered to be part of the child labor, and some they are not even considered as child labor. While boys are likely to take leaves and work outside home, so that is also considered to be child labor, because as I mentioned, kids who've been denied of school education and made to work somewhere else are considered to be a child labor. So the child labor, we can also call it as a child slavery or child exploitation. So what is the legal terms of legal age group for to not to be a child labor? According to according to India, the Basic Condition of Employment Act, it is a criminal offense to employ a child who is younger than 15. So when they are doing performing an act, where only a child can act in a serial, a child can act in a movie or certain things. But other than that, where it stops them from formal education, where it disturbs them physically, emotionally, and so that is not permitted. And even for a child below 15 years who want to act in a serial, so they need to get permission from Department of Labor. So children aged 15 to 18 years are definitely may not be employed to do work which are not appropriate for their age, or work in harmful places, risky, harmful, very risky places. So I want to mention this because when we talked about gratitude and how much we are doing more, there are certain set of people who don't get those privileges of having leading a very peaceful life. There are many reasons considered to be child labor. The first reason is the poverty in most of the countries. And it's not just in India, it's almost all over the world. Poverty is the first reason for making child to work and earn money and deprive them of the formal education. Let's discuss more about it, and maybe we can talk about how to how we can help us to eradicate this child labor. So before that, let me move on to the next part of this meeting, which is the impromptu communications in the table topic session. And today, today's table topic table topics is going to be active listening project for Toastmaster Sarath. Toastmaster Sarath is going to be a table topic master, as you all know. He is a PhD scholar, pursuing his PhD in IIT Madras, and he likes teaching kids, and he is a very active and passionate Toastmaster. You could see him taking up whenever there's a speaking slot available, and I can teach him anytime to deliver a speech. And today he is going to do an active listening part of the Toastmasters project. And to evaluate his role as a table topic master, we have a distinguished Toastmaster, Meena Jan. I request DTM Meena Jan to explain this project objective. Over to you, Meena Jan.
Thank you, sir. Toastmaster Sharad is doing the active listening thing project. The purpose of this project is for the member to demonstrate his or her ability to listen to what others say. Very simple objectives. Back to you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you, EDT Meena Chandra. And now, I request Toastmaster Sarath to take the control over from here and take us to the tabletop session for the next 15 to 20 minutes. Over to you, Toastmaster Sarath.
Thank you, Toastmaster of the day, Toastmaster Lakshmi Narayanan. Welcome, everyone, and welcome to the most exciting session of any Toastmasters meeting, that is TT session. What I will get from this session? What skill am I going to develop? Let me tell a few. Listening, impromptu speaking, organizing, critical thinking, time management. There's a lot of skills that we will be able to develop with this session. So how it goes? I'll be very simple. I'll be giving a simple topic to speak. Anyone from the audience, preferably non-role players, can participate. And I'll be giving a topic. You have to speak for a minimum of 1 minute. At the end of 1 minute, timer will show a green card. Timer, can you please show the green card?
Able to display this.
Yeah, so you will put in chat.
Speech, yeah.
Yeah, at the end of 1 minute, you'll reach the minimum time. At the end of 1 minute, 30 seconds, you'll reach the intermediate time. At the end of 2 minutes, you will reach the maximum. You have 30 seconds for you to wind up your speech. If you speak more than 2 minutes, 30 seconds, you will not be eligible for voting for the best TT speaker. So without much ado, let's begin our TT session for today. So to call our first speaker, we have Audacious Toastmaster, who already given his name to me. And I will tell the topic first, and then I will call the speaker. The topic is a quote: "Believe you can, and you are halfway there." Believe you can, and you are halfway there. Toastmaster Abhilash Suresh.
Thank you so much, Mr. Table Topic Master, and a very warm good evening, fellow Toastmasters and dear guests. Believe, and you're already halfway there. I would like to actually amend this quote a little. Believe, and you're already done. Let me tell you all one particular incident from my life which reinforced my confidence in this particular quote. So around 3-4 years back, when I was in my 12th grade, what happened was, just a couple of months before I was due to sit for my board exams, I was riding a bike in the morning and I had a huge accident. My entire right arm was fractured, and that meant I was to be in hospital for at least 1 month. And I thought, okay, 1 month is not a big time, so I will definitely get out and go in time for my board exams. And with that feeling, I was sitting when the doctor came and he told me, well, your right arm is going to take a long time for you to actually start writing and doing all things. I'm expecting a minimum 3 months time, but yet my exam was just in 2 months time, and I lost all hope, and I was sitting so dejected and down when my mom, she came in and she told me, why are you dejected? And I told her, well, doctor is saying 3 months, but my exam is in 2 months. Does that mean I'm going to sit for 1 year fully? What am I going to do? And at that time, golden words that she said, don't worry. 1 month or 2 months is a long time, and anything can happen. She told me, believe, be confident, and don't worry. Things will definitely go in. After all, faith is the thing that moves mountains. She told me, stay positive, believe in yourself. And the end result was, let me tell you, I not only recovered in time, I managed to write my exams and I passed top of my school. So that was the level to which I found this quote to be true. Believe, and it's not half done. Believe, and it is already fully done. Won't you agree, Table Topic Master? Back to you.
Of course, Toastmaster Abhilash, thank you so much for giving an inspirational, true life moments that you had when you had done with your 12th grade and had severe accident. And you also inspired us a lot. Thank you so much for sharing that and inspiring us. Moving on to the next topic, may I have Toastmaster Gandhi? I need two participants, Toastmaster Gandhi and Toastmaster Vignesh.
Yes, sir, I'm in.
Yeah, yes, Zoom sir. Master, can you spotlight them?
Yes,
Toastmaster Gandhi, I can see. Toastmaster Vignesh. Zoom Master, can you spotlight Toastmaster Vignesh? Yeah. So I'll give 30 seconds of time. You have to go search around in your room, quickly pick up an object. You have 30 seconds. Within that, just go quickly take some object and come. Fast. Your time starts now.
Any object, right?
Okay. Right. So you 10 seconds. Thank you. So first, I'll go with Toastmaster Gandhi. Toastmaster Gandhi, you talk of, you showed what? Can you show that object again? Yeah.
So what about
Toastmaster Gandhi, your topic is, you have to talk about why you love that water bottle so much. Why you love that water bottle so much? Toastmaster Gandhi.
Thank you for this creative topic today, Toastmaster Sarat. And good evening, fellow Toastmasters and guests. And a good question, why I love this particular water bottle? Because this water bottle was given as a gift to my daughter by some stranger on the 1st of January. It's every time, you know, when you get a gift, on a auspicious day, it's something special to you. And that too, when you get something from a stranger who's not meant anything to you. We stayed in a hotel in Coimbatore. We went to that Kovai Kutralam and we stayed there. And we stayed there by 31st night. And by first morning, when we vacated the room, and this bottle was given as a gift to my daughter by the receptionist. We never expected it. And moreover, let's think about what it carries. Yes, it carries the predominant, material or that supports the life here, right? Water. That's what everyone is dying for. And I'll take this opportunity to encourage everyone to even, place some water outside your house so that the birds can drink some water, and some water near your gate, even the stray dogs can drink that water. I would like to take this opportunity to stress to the world that this world, this planet is not meant only for the humans, it's also for every living being. So let's treat everyone equal and let's give them water. Thank you for giving this opportunity, Toastmaster Sarat.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Gandhi. I'm sure even if someone give you, I think 1 lakh or 1 crore, you will not give that water bottle because you are loving that so much. Thank you.
True, thanks.
Now to Toastmaster Vignesh. I know you are prepared with your topic, but I am not going to ask that. So Toastmaster Vignesh, your topic is your life. You showed Everyday battery, right?
Yes.
Yeah. So your life as the Everyday battery in Toastmaster Vignesh house. I repeat, your life as a battery in Toastmaster Vignesh house.
Okay. So life in a Vignesh, a life as a battery in a Vignesh home is really audacious. So it is taking a lot of opportunities as well. So you say without time is very important for all of us. So what time is driving us every day, but the thing which driving the time, so we have a wall clock there, so the clock need to run, so something need to drive the clock, so that important role is played by my Everyday battery. So it is really if one day every day I'm watching the time and I attend the meeting on the exact time. So these and all comes from only with the battery. So battery is much more important than anything, right? So it is like, as Gandhi told, right, water is the essential for all the living things. That is similar to all the electronics things. Battery is very important. Just to think, if you didn't have a battery in your laptop, how will you join the meeting? So it is very crucial part of nowadays life. So battery is very important in Vignesh home. So I have a lot of battery, you know, you see. So I have not one battery, so I have two batteries. So phone is went, so I will have another one. I have a rechargeable battery. So it is like a life to electronics. So without a life, electronics will not perform. So yes, thank you. Over to you, TT Master.
Thank you, Mr. Battery. I hope you are enjoying very much in Vignesh home, and you are also so productive. Thank you so much. I wish you come to my home also. I also have battery, but I think you are the most efficient one. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you, Toastmaster Vignesh. Zoom Master, you can remove the spotlight. Next, can we have any guest who would like to volunteer? Any guest? Any guest would like to volunteer? Okay. Okay, I'm not seeing. Maybe we'll go with Toastmaster. Next, I would like to call Toastmaster Anirudh. Toastmaster Anirudh, are you available?
Yes, sir. Am I audible?
Yeah. So the next set of topics which I'm going to give is, you have to complete a story. Fine, you have to complete a story. I'll give the starting line and you have to use your creativity to complete the story, right? Here goes your topic. The story starts like this. It was a hybrid meeting, me and Dash. I repeat, it was a hybrid meeting, me and Dash. Toastmaster Anirudh.
Thank you, Toastmaster Sarath. Let me begin my story. It was a hybrid meeting. It was me and my sister. The thing was, I was already a senior Toastmaster. I was a DTM. And then I was very experienced Toastmaster and giving my nth speech. While my sister, it was more of a icebreaker. She was just beginning her speech. The thing is, well, in a icebreaker, she was telling more about her troublesome cousin who always used to irritate her when she was a child. And then she spoke for a really long time, like nearly 4 minutes about that particular cousin. But then in table topic session, when it came to me, I was given the topic by Toastmaster Lakshmi Narayana, and he just asked me to talk about my cousin who always grew up with me. And then I grew up telling more embarrassing stories about her, as she said the same. So in the end of the meeting, both of us told a lot of very important things about each other, which we never spoke to each other in the beginning in the front at all. So at the end of the meeting, we learned many new things about each other, which we never learned before. Thank you, Toastmaster Sarath.
Thank you, Toastmaster Anirudh. I would request you to bring your sibling to the next hybrid meeting and make it happen really. Thank you. Next, any guest would like to volunteer? Can we have guest Saravana? It's going to be a very simple topic. Whatever comes in your mind, you can talk. Any guest would like to volunteer?
Hi, Sharat. I'll take.
Yeah, Saravana. Thank you. Thank you.
So my name is Vijay. I just joined today.
Fine. Yeah. So your topic, same story. I will give you a line. You have to complete the story. Right. So your story starts like this. It was an early morning, 6 o'clock. It was an early morning, 6 o'clock. Dash. Guess, Vijay.
Okay. Hi. So it was a very wonderful early morning, 6 o'clock. You know, like I was in the Elagiri estate. You know, me and my family. You know, the entire family came yesterday night, one day before, and the next day morning by 6 o'clock, we are all going for a pleasant walk. You know, the next to the there was a big pond. There was a boat house and nearby to the place where we stay are there, and as well as the shops, you know, the tea shop. So we had a nice tea, and we just went quiet where we were, and all we wanted to visit the places, you know, like, so the all the list of sightseeing, we were inquired with XYZ persons, and also like then we just, our journey started my morning by 6 o'clock, and then we went to the travel agent. We were inquiring about where we wanted to go and what is the tariff of the price of the vehicle cost and the hotel cost, everything, etc. So that's how we started in the morning. Thank you.
You can continue. You can continue. Whatever comes in your mind, keep on going.
Okay. So we just we were on the way, and then we started, and so by the time it was 6:30, after the inquiries were, by the time it was 6:30, and then we went to one show, the small hotel. We had our coffee and tea for the refreshment, and then the journey started, and then we are just moving to the side viewpoint, like viewpoints, and then we are all took a cab and then moving on to there. And then we went to a hotel, and then we are all having our breakfast. And then immediately my son wanted to get down in particular place where he wanted to take some photographs. We all joined there and then enjoyed the place. And surprisingly, like we met some, one of the, my ex-friend, you know, like I met my friend, and he also came there with his family members. And then we were discussing where you are going and which place you are planning to move on to the next. And then we both together and started in to moving together to see all the sight scenes, you know, like. And then the time goes like this, you know, like we are just moving to one place and enjoying the climate in the Elagiri. And then so by the time it was 12:30, we all went to one good restaurant. We are planning to have our lunch as well. Then the journey going again, we are continuing our journey, and then by 3:30 we are just coming to back to the resort. Thank you, Sharad.
Thank you guest Vijay for wonderfully narrating the story. Just to add out, if you come at 4 o'clock, we have CTM meeting. You and your brother can come and join here next time. Thank you so much for beautifully creatively narrating the story.
Thank you, Toshmada sir.
Yeah. Next, any guest would like to volunteer? It's going to be a very easy topic. So any guest would like to volunteer? Same story format. It's going to be very easy. I'm sure you will attend. Any guest would like to volunteer? Yes. Guest Yadav, Yadesh, you want to?
Yeah, okay, sir. I'll just take this opportunity.
Thank you. So Yadesh, your story line starts like this, very easy. Once upon a time.
Once upon a time, we and my friend were coming to the park where we sitting in the boats, and we both sit in the one place and seeing the sunrises. We see an old friend who's coming from there in the long way ago, and we just talked about the future plans and goals to be achieved. So early morning is a fresh mind to think about the futures and future goals to be attended. We all are in the same college and schoolmates. So he just talked about his ambitions. He wants to become a computer engineer, and my other friend wants to become a doctor. I just said, I just have any other ideas to become what? What should I become in my future? So they all dig a, sorry, sir. Suggestment.
Yeah, just whatever comes in your mind, you just keep on going. You are going very beautifully. Keep on going. Yeah, I think there is a network issue from Yadish. Right. Thank you. Thank you so much, Yadish, for narrating the story beautifully. Thank you so much. Next, I would like to call Toastmaster Renuga. Toastmaster Renuga, would you please unmute?
Yeah, I'm here.
Yeah. Toastmaster Renuga, can you tell me something? Yeah, you are audible. Toastmaster
okay,
Renuga.
Thank you.
Can you tell me some famous celebrity you like? It may be some politician or cricketer, actor in the past, in the present, or some name.
Yeah, one of the famous celebrity. Yeah, very good evening to one and all.
No, that's not the topic. That's a question I'm asking. Topic is still awaiting.
Okay. You're just asking me to say who is a celebrity, right?
Yeah, some name. I just need some name.
APJ Abdul Kalam.
Okay, good.
He's one of the most honorable person.
Right. So here is your topic. Assume or imagine you met APJ Abdul Kalam, sir, last night in a special social occasion. Assume you have met APJ Abdul Kalam, sir, in a special social occasion. Describe your meeting with him. Describe your meeting with him. Toastmaster Renuga.
Yeah, good evening to everyone. So, meeting APJ Abdul Kalam is one of the greatest moments and it could never happen, but still it might be an imagination. It would be an embarrassing moment and I'd be very happy. And we might have been discussing to say about the description of the meeting, it would be science and development or science and technology development. How can the cultivation can be done, or how can grow up the youngsters? His ideology to bring the nation big through the youngsters, and I can share some ideas and also get some advices to grow up the children of today, who are going to become the pillars of tomorrow. Since I'm in the field of teaching, I used to meet so many students, so many youngsters every day, and getting his advice, it would be very helpful for me to grow the children for tomorrow's India. So this might be my discussion about the growth of the children today and about science and technology. How can you improve the society? So this might be my meeting concept towards APJ Abdul Kalam. I think so. Over to you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Renuga, for wonderfully narrating the meeting experiences as if it were really happening. I'm sure you will be working towards the science and technology and development of children in the future as ambition. Thank you so much. Next, I would like to call one Toastmaster who will always attend the meeting, but will start the meeting, but he will be very quiet in TT session. Now I'm going to pull out that person. Toastmaster Vishnu, available?
Yes, I'm available.
Yes. So Toastmaster Vishnu, your topic is a quote. People said, follow your dreams. So I went back to bed. People said, follow your dreams. So I went back to bed. Toastmaster Vishnu.
Thank you, Toastmaster Sarath, for this very imaginative topic. As you said, I feel like I want to go to bed and continue my dream. But since you pulled me out of this crowd, I will say like, okay, so I feel like this is like a right topic for me, because even though people say like star dreaming, I think everyone does that. When they go to bed, we quite often we don't get that sleep. We spend the hours till 12 a.m., 1 a.m., 2 a.m. and we don't know what we do, but you just dream. Sometimes, especially during my college, when I think about projects, final years, and all I could dream of is what I'll be doing, what I'm going to do my studies after that, and I'll start dreaming. Even though we don't achieve it, especially right after my first job interview and after getting that appointment letter, my dream was, I went after marriage, after retirement, what I will do, my dreams went beyond that. So dreams, we can never stop them. So even though that we are dreaming during before our sleep or dreaming during the daytime, do dream. Okay, please do that. Dream is the one which is going to improve your creativity. And even if you don't have time, just sit simply during a daytime, close your eyes and dream. Okay, it will create your, to improve your creativity and to also create new goals. You will not realize that even though you are in a lot of troubles, at some point, without out of your consciousness, you'll get some idea, you'll get some solution towards the troubles are also, okay? So dream, either during daytime or during your sleep, dream. Thank you, and back to you, Toastmaster. Sir.
Thank you, Dream Master. Sorry, Toastmaster Vishnu. It was like kind of educational session of why one should have dream. Thank you so much for beautifully elaborating. And next, I would like to call Toastmaster Ashwini. Toastmaster Ashwini, are you available? Any volunteers, any guests who would like to volunteer? It's going to be a very simple topic. I'll say the topic and then I'll ask your. So the topic is your childhood days. Guest Sandhya, are you available? Okay, I think some network issue. I have DTM Nina John. Ma'am, can you go with one topic, last topic?
No, Sharath, I'm your evaluator.
Okay.
Conflict of interest.
Okay.
Not allowed.
Thank you. So I think with this, we can close our TT session. Thank you so much all for participating audaciously and making this a beautiful session. Thank you. Over to you, Toastmaster of the day.
Thank you, Toastmaster Sarath, for a wonderful session. It's not like the usual table topic session. You covered various topics, various ideas as well. You made people to speak. And first thing I want to appreciate is that even if people are hesitating to talk, you made them to wait there, listen to them, made them to talk. So I'm not going to talk beyond this because the evaluator will do more about it. So with that, are we coming to the end of this table topic session? And I think let's move on to the next session. This is going to be evaluation session where we're going to evaluate the two prepared speakers and the table topic speaker as well. I would like to invite Toastmaster Abhirami, the general evaluator, to take the control over and lead us from there. Over to you, Toastmaster.
Thank you, Toastmaster Lakshmi. So yes, the evaluation team is back. So I'm here to introduce the second team, my set of evaluators who will be giving concrete evaluations and feedbacks to all our champion speakers today. Now on the list, first we have the first evaluator, Toastmaster Hamsika. She will be evaluating Toastmaster Vivekanandan's speech. He has already done a fabulous job by starting his journey of 1,000 miles with an icebreaker. I'm sure Hamsika will do a great job giving concrete feedback for the icebreaker speech. Before I hand over the stage to Hamsika, I'll give a few words about her. So Hamsika is doing her MBA in an international management of management institute, and presently she's a president, Toastmaster president of IMI Kolkata Toastmasters Club. She's doing her internship at Carrot Lane in Chennai, and her hobbies are painting and baking. So now Toastmaster Geeta, you have company for baking. That's great. So over to you, Toastmaster Hamsika.
Thank you so much for the introduction, Madam General Evaluator. Toastmaster Vivek, no one could believe that this was your first ever speech, because it did not feel like your first speech. It really felt like you've been in Toastmasters for a long time when we heard your speech, because we could clearly see that you were enjoying yourself while giving that speech of yours, and you were really enjoying the entire process. So of course, your speech had so many good things, but due to the shortage of time, I'll be pointing out only a few. So the first thing I really liked about your speech is that you satisfied the criteria of it being an icebreaker. From talking about your playing hockey to cricket to sports competitions, and also about your engineering and your dislike towards maths, and talking about doing an MBA and then winning an Employee of the Year award. There's so many things which all the audience got to know about you today. And that is the entire motive of an icebreaker speech, which you 100% satisfied. Another thing which I really liked about your speech was the structure. I really love the way you structured your speech, and you divided your entire speech into three phases. You talked about phase one, where it involved around your school life, phase two, where it involved around your college life, and phase three, where you were talking about your work. And that's such an excellent way to write your speech and give your speech, so that we understand each and every piece of your life so beautifully and clearly. Another thing which I really loved about your speech was the beautiful message at the end. It's always good to leave the audience with something to take back at the end of the speech, and you were able to do it in your first ever speech. Those last couple of motivational lines where you said that, don't get afraid of failures, enjoy the process, it's the journey that matters, was so good. And I'm sure all the audience, all of us sitting here, were truly inspired by what you said. But to make your speech a super hit speech the next time you give it, which I'm sure you will, there are some areas which you can work on, and I'm sure you're going to give that blockbuster speech. And for the first one, it would be really helpful, Toastmaster Vivek, if you could stand and give your speech. So that's how usually Toastmaster speeches, it has a better impact for the audience when you're standing and giving your speech, so that we can see your upper half of your body. So that way you can use some body language, you can use your arms well, and you won't be in a stiff position. And also, I think today you did have some issues with the internet, because your video was getting stuck, which I completely understand. In an online meeting, these are the kind of hiccups we would have. So that is completely understandable, Toastmaster Vivek. The other thing which would have made your speech or taken it to another level is showing the emotions, especially when you're talking about giving your exams, and when you talked about certain down areas in your life, it would have been nice if you had given that emotion and maybe talked about that in a slightly lower voice. But then when you got your job and you got the Employee of the Year award, and you also got a HR award, at that time, if you had shown that enjoyment and if you had shown that happiness in your expressions, that would have really made us feel like we are living the experience with you. But all in all, Toastmaster Vivek, just make sure that you check your internet connection before you give your speech. And it would be way better if you could stand and give your speech. But overall, your speech structure was amazing. Your entire story, and we got to know about you from your childhood till today. So that was a wonderful job, Toastmaster Vivek. And I'm sure you have a long way to go in Toastmasters Club. Thank you, and over to you, Madam General Evaluator.
Thank you for the evaluation. Thank you.
Thank you, Toastmaster Hamsika, for that very detailed evaluation. I'm sure it will be a lot of things for our Toastmaster Vivekanandan to follow. And I'm sure he's going to make a note of them and follow them for his next speech. Thank you so much. Now to evaluate the second speech, we have a veteran Toastmaster, Toastmaster Srikanth. Now, if you see, there is a beautiful mix. The first speech was a icebreaker and the second one is a seasoned speech. And now for this speech, to say a few words about Toastmaster Srikanth, he's working with the central government. He's working in the central government service. And when I asked him what makes him happy or what is it something special in his life, he says that whenever he wakes up in the morning, he always has a positive vibe that God has promised something good for him in that day. And his hobbies are gardening and reading. So with this introduction, let me request Toastmaster Srikanth to evaluate the Toastmaster Geeta's speech. Over to you.
Thank you very much, General Evaluator. It's always a pleasure to hear you introduce me to the audience. Good afternoon, everybody. Toastmaster Geeta, I would be evaluating your speech on two aspects. The first would be that how you were driving home the point that the attitude of gratitude is something that each and every one of us need to have. Because what you truly meant by that is, when you are grateful for each and every good thing that is happening to you or to any one of us, we get more and more opportunities to be grateful for. And you started off with two beautiful stories. One was a story of a grandmother with a grandson who was swept away. The small son, the grandson was swept away, and she was literally panicking. She didn't know, but she looked up and she prayed. And the second wave brought back the young boy to the shore, but the cap was missing. She was grateful, but at the same time, she was complaining, where you said that we really miss out on what the blessings are, and we also start complaining what is lacking. That's a very powerful story. If you think and try to reflect upon that, that's a very important message that you have conveyed to us. And you also were so good in conveying a personal experience that you had when you had a home for yourself and you moved in there, but you were still not happy. The vibes were not good. You had all reasons to complain that this was not the place that you wanted to be. And your son stepped in, and how he convinced you is very interesting. So again, you are telling us that the attitude of gratitude, not necessarily that we learn by ourselves, any person in our family or friends can teach us, and we need to get that attitude of being grateful for everything. That's very interesting. Two very interesting stories, which I think you have stamped your authority without any doubt or without any hesitation, telling us that this is what you need to follow. Very well done. And as I told you, the second aspect that I want to evaluate your speech is about the feedback that was given to you to dramatize your speech. That was an interesting recommendation that was given by the previous evaluator in your first speech, and you have done that. I could see that you had a very good facial expression whenever you're looking up, your hands were moving around, everything was picture perfect. But I feel you're missing out on the frame of the picture where you could have stood up and given us a more powerful moving around, stepping forward, coming back, especially when you had a conversation with your son. It was something that where you could raise your voice or just drop, listen to him with an awe in your face. And that kind of an expression would give the audience how much of depth that you have, the conviction that you have in your speech and in your attitude of being grateful would have been more impactful to all of us. So these are the things that I want you to work on, to be grateful and also to have this attitude of having more of a conversation, standing up and talking to us. So to give you a brief summary, you are a good storyteller. You're driving home the point that attitude needs to be there, but also see that you make it more impactful, playing a little around with your voice and also with standing and speaking to all of us. I wish you all the very best. Thank you, and back to you, General Evaluator.
Thank you, Toastmaster Srikanth, for that fabulous evaluation. Now it's time to call upon the third evaluator. So now this evaluation is slightly different, that our evaluator will be evaluating the TT Master's performance in the table topics. I'm sure she will elaborate on what exactly is the requirement for this particular task. So before I call her upon stage, I would like to give a few words of introduction about her. So this is something that I always love reading, her introduction specifically, because we all sometimes, you know, we don't realize how lucky we are to have a senior member in the club to guide us to what we do with a lot of perfection. So Nina Ma'am is the charter member of Chennai Toastmasters Club and the first area, division and district governor of Tamil Nadu. She has also been the former chief judge of District 82 and she's currently the mentor pool chair of District 120. She is the author of the book, Navigating the Corporate Seas, which is a book on management tools and techniques. And she loves mentoring and is an executive coach for public speaking and life skills. I try to make it as short as possible. So this is what I could get. Over to you, Nina Ma'am.
Thank you so much, Madam Toastmaster Abhiravi, for that introduction. And good evening to everyone. Toastmaster Sharad's project is on listening skills. When we joined Toastmasters, we are all so happy being public speakers, orators. We're going to, you know, win the world with our oratory. We forget that one of the most important skills for a public listener, for a public speaker, is to learn how to listen. And this is one of the projects which specifically shows us what can you do to improve your listening skills. I think Toastmaster Sharad did a fabulous job. He had, first of all, he gave an introduction of why table topics and how table topics helps us in our daily life, which I really liked. I mean, that is something that most people tend to forget. And the fact that we have table topics as a skill involves, first of all, the audience listening carefully to the topic and then responding. So that's one very important part of table topics. The other is, as table topics master, have you listened to the topic and are you able to analyze it, speak something on that and transition smoothly onto the next topic or the next speaker? All of these, I think Toastmaster Sharad did a great job. What I also liked is the fact that he had variety, wonderful variety in terms of either just topics, start a story, or even like a very funny thing about, the last one was really funny about sleep on and dream on and things like that. So that's the kind of variety that adds spice to table topics. That's what really builds up a club's thing. And what I also liked about Toastmasters Sharad is the fact that he had a very encouraging attitude. See, that's very important, the way he encouraged all the different speakers. Yes, carry on, go on, you know, carry on. This is the way it is. Excellent way of encouraging people who are a little nervous or you're not sure about what you want to say. Because the thing about table topics is we know all about the subject after we have gone home. But when someone calls you to speak, we freeze. So it's nice to have that positive attitude both before you start speaking and after you started speaking. And again, for his transitions, he used keywords from whatever the speaker had said and said, okay, Vignesh, so yeah, and referred, for example, to Vignesh, not Vignesh, as a dream master, Vishnu actually, yeah, referred to Vishnu as a dream master as part of his speech, picked up different sentences from the other speaker. Overall, great job. And as a Toastmaster, what I also liked was the icing on the cake, where he subtly slipped in messages of wonderful, please bring your sister, brother, slash friend to Toastmasters next time. So we had a great marketing campaign going on and promoting of Toastmasters. So overall, I thoroughly enjoyed Toastmaster Sharad's table topics. I think he did a great job of listening. And I think we can, those are the lessons we can take back. When a client is speaking, what are they saying? What are the keywords? What do I need to pay attention to? Those are all the things that we learn from table topics and Toastmasters. And I think Toastmaster Sharad did a great job with some audacious topics, if you want me to use the word of the day. Back to you, Madam General Evaluator.
Thank you, distinguished Toastmaster Nina John, for that detailed evaluation on the table topics. That's when people realize how much is going behind the table topics. Thank you so much for that. So now it's time to call upon my first team, the tag team, to give their feedback. So let me request the timer onto the stage. Toastmaster Palaniswamy, over to you. Palni, you're on mute.
Yeah, good evening. Just I'm trying to share my apologies because, you know, I'm not able to share the screen. So the initial time I struggled, then I directly messaged to the speakers. I'll be trying to share the screen now. So I hope everyone can see this, the timer report.
Yes.
To start with, SAA TM Vishnu started the meeting. He took one minute 35 seconds for the introduction. Presiding officer Toastmaster Abhirami took an introductory speech of 2 minutes 30 seconds. And secretary report took 1 minute 50 seconds by Toastmaster Vignesh. Toastmaster of the day, Toastmaster Lakshminarayana took two minutes 30 seconds for the introductory speech. Overall, that the first speech is about 4 minutes 30 seconds. And the prepared speech speakers, Toastmaster Vivek took 4 minutes 40 seconds. He is qualified for the voting. Toastmaster Geeta took 8 minutes to complete the prepared speech. The table topic overall, it took 28 minutes to complete the session. Toastmaster Abhilash took 2 minutes 15 seconds. Toastmaster Gandhi took 1 minute 40 seconds. Toastmaster Vignesh took 1 minute 45 seconds to complete the speech. Toastmaster Anirudh took 1 minute 25 seconds. Guest Vijay took 2 minutes 40 seconds. Toastmaster Renova took 1 minute 50 seconds. Toastmaster Vishnu took 1 minute 50 seconds. In the evaluation, Toastmaster Hamsika took 3 minutes 20 seconds to complete the evaluation. Toastmaster Srikant Kutikrishnan took 3 minutes 25 seconds to complete the evaluation. DTM Nina John took 3 minutes 45 seconds to complete the evaluation. Thank you, and over to you.
Thank you, Toastmaster Palani Sami. I think in the interest of the timing glitch that we had, we'd have to mark the not qualified members also as qualified because we were not able to flash the flag.
Yes.
Yeah, thank you.
Yeah.
So Zoom Master, kindly note that and update the polls accordingly. Now it's time to call upon the second member from the tag team, our counter, Toastmaster Mathu, over to you.
Thanks, Abhirami. Let me share the screen.
Palani Sami, please stop sharing the screen.
Yeah, yes.
Yeah, are you able to see the screen? Can you hear me, Abhirami?
Yes, visible.
Okay, thank you. So these are the encounter report from today's session. So today's meeting, Vishnu, you used the word "and" in one time, and then the Lakshminarayana, the Toastmaster of the day, he the encounter, the word you are using 3+ times, and I'm using one time, and the pass is taking long time, and we are framing the sentence from one sentence to another sentence. So these are the complete report and general evaluator Abhirami using the word in one time, used word in one time. And then Palani Sami and the timer they are using for hours one time. And then Sivakumar, grammarian, is also so, they're using the word so one time and also the and using the one time. So from the prepared speakers, so Toastmaster Vivekananda, using 3+ times and framing the sentence from one, connecting between one sentence to another sentence, taking long gap. Also the Toastmaster Geeta, the speakers, she using the word so with one time. And come to the table topics, Toastmaster Sarath, the TT master, using the our word one time and so is one time. Come to the table top speaker, the Abhilash Suresh, eyes using one time and bell the bird using one time. And Toastmaster Kanti, so the hawk counter using three times and the bird using one time. And come to Toastmaster Vignesh, is passing long gap when we are starting with the Toastmaster table topics. So guest Yadesh is taking, or is taking two times and passes over time. And then come to Vishnu, so he's again, yeah, is taking three times, or is taking three plus time. And Toastmaster Renuka, I is taking three plus time, and Om is one time and passes one time. And I really apologies because I'm not able to enter that because my Excel has crashed. So I'm not able to enter that something this one. So that's what I am. The last guest, Vijay, the table topic speaker, he is used to the R counter is three times. So come to this general evaluator. So the Toastmaster Hamsika, so the R word is using one time, and then DTM Nina Jan, so the R counter is one time and the pass one time. So these are the detailed report from the R counter.
Thank you. To hear from the grammarian, Toastmaster Shivakumar, over to you.
Thank you, Toastmaster Abhiravati. First, at the outset, let me take opportunity to appreciate Toastmaster Vignesh and Toastmaster Sharad for having used the word of the day. Thanks for that. And the good usage of words Toastmaster Vivekananda used, upskill, courage, and don't get afraid of failure. Toastmaster Geeta used, when you look through the eyes of gratitude, everything changes magically. For that. And Postmaster Kranti knows this planet does not meant only for human. So these are the good words that I have observed. And apart from that, misusage of English words, there are not many, but I have just taken note of few things. Instead of I was to be, it has to be like I had to. Instead of using it's crucial, it's apt to use, it's essential. So other than that, all the speakers have efficiently used their English language. Thanks for that. And over to you, Toastmaster Abhiram.
I'm sorry, I just had a glitch. Is the grammarian report over?
Yes.
Okay, great. Thank you so much. Now it's time to hear my report for today. So first I'll go with what went well in today's meeting. So to start with, there were almost 15 members who joined the bridge before the meeting, almost 10 minutes or 5 minutes before the meeting, which is a really good sign. So all the members were there around to do the audio and video check. So I appreciate that. And most importantly, the meeting started on time. And we are continuing the CTM's best practice of reading out the secretarial report. That is also really good. We have, I noted that we have 7 guests today. That's a good sign of the BBPR activities in place and the outreach that CTM has. Overall, to talk about the meeting, I think the speeches today were really amazing. We had a wide variety, an icebreaker, and also a seasoned speech. Both the speeches were very wonderful. I just love the way Geeta ma'am gave all those expressions. I'm sure we could see the transition from icebreaker to a seasoned Toastmaster, what change that brings. I think that is something the guests would be able to visualize. And also the icebreaker, a lot of courage to the first speaker who has delivered his icebreaker, which is a big thing. Once you break the ice, it just flows. So congratulations to both of you. To mention about the TT session, it was very, very unique and innovative. I think I did not repeat it because the evaluator, distinguished Toastmaster Inajan, completely gave a beautiful evaluation. So the TT session was very, very engaging and the unique element for today. And overall, I think all the guests were also participating in the TT session. So that way, it was a very engaging meeting for all the guests as well. Now, certain things that we can look for improvement. First thing, I think we had some glitch on the timer cards today. So this could have been avoided if we had properly checked the screen sharing at the start, and appropriately we could have communicated via group chat regarding the issue so that people are informed and accordingly they keep an eye on the chat. Otherwise, people will not, the members will not know that they need to look at the chat because they're trying to see the screen share. So that is something that we could have managed better. And to talk about the meeting, I think there are some unique elements we should embed, because CTM as a club, we generally have all these prepared speech and all the elements. I think we should have at least one unique element, like a game or an educational session or any small piece that can be new and refresh the whole setting. So that is something I would recommend. I think the teamwork poster was not out. So that is something that we would need to work on to get the posters out on time. The last thing that I wanted to add was, I think we had 27 or 26 members and 11 or 10 members had the videos on. Yes, people will not be sometimes able to have it switched on the whole of the time, but they can try to switch it on during the part of the time. That will be very encouraging to all the members. So overall, I think it had been a great meeting and we can always improve and make it a better one the next time. So with this, thank you so much for the opportunity, and I'll hand back the stage over to the Toastmaster of the day. Over to you, Toastmaster Lakshmi.
Thank you, Toastmaster Abhirami and your team for wonderful evaluations. Thank you so much. And okay, now we are coming to the end of this meeting. All the three important portions of this meeting is done. So I just want to go with the theme and give my last point of inputs regarding this theme, which I'm talking about the child labor, anti-child labor. So as we discussed, mentioned about all the points and what is this child labor and what are the statistics about it's talking about, let's just quickly see how we can stop this child labor in India. So I don't want to take too much time on this part. I'm going to put in only 4 points. The first thing is the most stringent law. Okay. The laws, the law already exists where it says that it's a criminal offense to employ a child younger than 15. Now, and that is very important. And even for the kids between 15 to 18 years, they can't be employed at a place where it's not safe for them. The occupational safety is very, very important for kids above 15 as well. So people should be aware of there is a law, and there's also child helpline to take care. And to make this aware, we need to spread the awareness to understand what are the consequences or effects of a child labor. Because we know there's a child labor, but we have to understand what is the consequence from child's perspective and the parents' perspective and the community as such. Because it affects the future of the child a lot, because we are depriving them of the education. There are places where people put them for a few hours of education, then put them on job. Even that is not sufficient for them. So we are depriving them of education. And then there are a lot of abuses happening, like corporal punishments, blaming, humiliating kids, and emotional neglect. And also, most importantly, I think, if we employ child labor, we are depriving the child of the family love and affection, which might lead them to loneliness as well. And all this physical, apart from the physical, emotional neglect, physical neglect is also there, like not sufficient shelter, food, medical. There are not many things, because why I'm saying this is for the awareness about what are the ill effects of the child labor and how we can help as a society, as a people, is that we don't see that much in cities, but when we come across even the rural areas, we need to help send more people to children to schools, which they are deployed in many places. And most importantly, we have to discourage people who employ children at home or shops. Because many times I've been seeing when I go out in a remote area, I will see kids who working there. If they ask their age, they'll just say 18, but they may not be really 18. But we can't go and fight, but we have to be aware they are employing children and do as much as possible to educate people to not do so things. There are a lot many points we need to discuss. Maybe in the interest of time, I'm going to restrict my speech here. With that note, we have to understand that child is meant to learn, not to learn at the young age. So with that note, Let me complete my role as a Toastmaster today and hand over the control back to the presiding officer, Toastmaster. Over to you, Toastmaster.
Thank you, Toastmaster of the Day, Toastmaster Lakshmi. I think today we have been playing musical chair from the start of the day, passing on to each other, and that is really wonderful. So now, yes, it's time to finish our meeting. So before that, let's do one thing. Let's have the polls on one side, request the Zoom master to launch the polls while we talk to the guests and get the recognitions done. So let me start with the guest feedback. Okay. Can I request guest Chandralekha onto the stage? We would like to hear a few words about you, Chandralekha, and how you know about the club, and how was your meeting experience today? Guest Chandralekha.
Hi, everyone. I'm Chandralekha here. I came to know about Toastmasters Club from one of our friends via Instagram. I was basically interested in public speaking, so I was looking for an opportunity to learn the skills and the ability to speak, everything, all sorts of the tips and tricks that you share here. I wanted to know officially. So I just wanted a platform to upskill my passion. So I just joined the club as a guest to get to know what exactly happens in the Toastmaster meetings.
That's great, Chandralekha. So did you enjoy today's meeting?
Yes, of course I did.
That's good to hear. Great. So next, can I request guest Saravanan to share his feedback? Yes, Saravanan.
Yeah, am I audible?
Yes, you're audible.
So my friend is Sanmugam Sundaram. He is in Dubai. Introduced me that you should attend that CTM. That definitely will improve your communication skill and improve your speaking skill. That is why I am attending here. It's a wonderful time I am spending here. Such a warm and very fresh, refreshing myself. Very thankful, CTM. Over to you.
Thank you. Thank you for those warm words, Saravanan. Looking forward that you will join us in the coming meetings as well.
Okay. Yes.
Thank you. Next, can we hear a few words from guest Vijay?
Hi, Abhirami. See, actually, I come to know about Toastmaster from my existing organization from one of my co-worker. We just thought of introduce a Toastmaster club in the in our company, and unfortunately we were not actually, but however they came for the demo actually. So that's how I come to know Toastmaster, and completely I have enjoyed the session. Basically I wanted to improve my communication skill in terms of talking with the public. So I'm sure I would like to learn more things from you people. Thank you for the opportunity.
Thank you, Vijay. Thank you so much. Next, can we hear from guest Yadesh?
Hi, ma'am. This is Yadesh. I know about this course by my father's colleague who's working in TCS. So I need to improve my English communication skills and stage fear, and I need to lose my stage fear. So just chosen this Toastmaster. I would really think that I will come up with this course and I'll do my best. And the and the classes was very interesting and more educative. Yeah, thanks, ma'am.
Thank you so much, Yadesh. I'm glad that you enjoyed the meeting. Now it's time for the recognitions. So even before recognizing, I would like to call out the first-time role players for today. So today we had Toastmaster Mathu performing the role of R counter for the first time. Congratulations, Mathu, for the very fabulous job. I'm sure you did a very detailed R counter report and very diligently you followed the instructions. So that was really good for the first time.
Thank you.
Now on the results for the speaking, the award winners. So the best tag role player is our R counter Toastmaster Mathu. Congratulations, Toastmaster Mathu.
Thank you all.
The best. Sorry, go ahead.
So this is actually before taking this the role. So I was connecting with the Lakshmi Narayana. So he is helping to. This is a way to do that R counter. Because this is the very first time I'm taking the charge, right? So I'm not sure how it's going on. Even I saw that observed from the previous meeting. But what happened when we have come to the my role, right? So taking the charge. So he is giving some ideas. So. Based on that, I have instructed and we that now the idea is very suitable. Now we do
that's very nice. That's very nice, Toastmaster Mathu. So that shows how much the VP puts in efforts to get the roles right.
Yep.
Thank you. So now on to the best speaker for today is the man who broke the ice, Toastmaster Vivekanand. Congratulations, Toastmaster Vivekanand.
Thank you.
The best table topic speaker is the first speaker for today, Toastmaster Abhilash. Congratulations, Toastmaster Abhilash. Oh my God. So you have a table topics ribbon right from the suitcase, is it? Nice. The best evaluator for today is the evaluator who evaluated the icebreaker, Toastmaster Hamsika. Congratulations, Toastmaster Hamsika. The best role player for today is myself, the general evaluator. Thank you so much for all the support. Now, the last piece on the recognition is we have this, we follow this custom that we will honor the icebreaker speech. So let us give a standing ovation to Vivekanand for his first icebreaker speech.
Thank you.
Yeah. So we are done with the meeting for today. It was a fantastic meeting. Thank you so much. On this note, I adjourn meeting number 531. We can stop recording and we can have the informal discussion a few minutes now, post which we will be having the VPM election for the post, I mean the election for the post of VPM, which will be a closed door meeting where the members alone can stay back. Stop recording.